Good as a P. One in a billion, and I'm back.
And it's your favorite diva, Dangerous Diva, and we are back with a special guest.
Listen, this is becoming a regular occurrence now.
Yes, we always have good shows when he's on.
Mr.
Jonathan Banks.
What's up, people? How y'all doing, man?
Heavyweight champion.
You know what I mean?
Here in the building.
Extraordinaire. If you don't know, look in the magazine. Get you a copy of the New Ring magazine. No, this is not him. This is B-Hop. Bernard Hop is in there. But
Center page.
You know what I mean? Go to page 45. See Mr. Banks over there. Some real good stories on him. Just page after page. You know what I mean?
They got some crazy pictures of him knocking Seth out. Did you see that picture? Oh my goodness. He was stumbled.
Shout out to Seth.
Oh man.
You know how to lay down perfectly.
Right?
They got nobody know how to lay down like him.
Look at that picture. They got, hey, I didn't put it in there. They did it.
We didn't do it. All right? So don't be mad. Listen. Other happenings going on since we on the fighting tip.
Yeah. Well,
your boy Chris Brown.
Oh no.
Chris Brown, he goes to a charity event. It's a charity event, what was it, Studio City or something like that?
Yeah.
Charity event out here in LA, and he wasn't being very charitable.
No. He let his temper get the best of him.
He didn't
once
have
again.
No money in his pocket.
It was over $10.
What was over $10?
His temper, like, temper flared. He was cussing out the valet because valet charged him $10. In the video, you'll see Chris Brown swearing at him, saying he's gonna F him up, him and his goons, his squad is there, and if he don't give him the keys,
he's about to get turned up in here.
Yeah, over $10, Chris Brown.
That's crazy.
Oh, can we have a prayer?
Yeah, so y'all go out and buy Chris Brown album so he can get $10 to pay for his valet.
You know what I mean? You got the clothing line, you got all this stuff going on.
You can't pay $10.
You can't pay these. Come on, man. You acting like these dudes own the company or something. It's just, you know, shout out to the Mexicans, you know, shout out to my Mexicanos.
You know, Poppy was trying to do his
little
job.
Little Poppy's just doing his job.
Me don't have.
He was trying to complete his honest day's work. Man.
He really was.
That's all he was trying to do. This man go come start fussing.
Yeah, got up in his face.
About $10, man.
Now,
I wish I was a valet that night.
What would happen if you were a valet?
You wouldn't have walked up on me with no $10. I'm telling you. His security guards would have grabbed me. Because I think I would have hit him.
Right? Now, he's always already tried to do damage control. He just released a statement saying that it wasn't the fact that it was over $10, it was the principle. He felt that valet was trying to get over on him because it was a $5 parking lot. And then when they saw him, because he's famous, they tried to charge him $10.
If it's a $5 parking lot and I seen a famous guy, I'ma charge him $50. Right? That's getting over. Another $5 is not getting over.
I mean,
$5 parking lot there, valet here. Why would the $5 parking lot be the same as the valet?
Yeah.
Everybody can say, why am I going valet? I might as well park on a $5 parking lot. Yeah. So it's $5 the valet too.
No, true.
It makes no sense.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, you know what I mean? This is somebody that's, like he said, they finishing their honest day's work.
Yeah.
Come on, man. You could have gave him that.
A tip.
You know what I'm saying?
A tip.
I don't know what I would have did in the same situation.
But
I ain't in your situation, so.
I know what I would have did. I mean, if I was in the Chris Brown situation, I just would have gave the guy $10 and walked away.
I gave him $10. What if you're not Chris Brown? What if you?
It's you, Jonathan Banks.
And I know I'm pulling up in valet, I'm going to give him $10.
Oh, if you pulling in valet.
I'm in valet. He pulling in valet.
Mm-hmm. And it's a charity event.
When you pull in valet, I don't care if they charge you $50.
It's valet.
If you shouldn't be in valet, if you can't be in valet.
Exactly. And it's one thing to act stupid than to actually, you know, let them know, like, if you think you're getting over on me, I saw the $5 sign up. You're losing by lying to me, but you know what? I'm going to go ahead and give it to you. Here you go, $10. Hopefully that'll help feed the children at home for you.
Exactly.
You know, take the high road.
All right, so.
But speaking of him.
Yeah, what else did he do?
Yeah.
He stays busy. You know what I mean? Power keeps him busy to keep him in the media.
Either it's him or it's Rihanna because she's sending naked pictures out. She's Instagramming thong shots. just showing
got
everything.
Got someone else on my phone. Thank you. I appreciate that.
So maybe she driving him nuts and he had to go run home and just be like, yeah, hopefully he handled that correctly. But speaking of Chris, he is in Bermuda. He stops to refuel his jet. While he's refueling his jet, he gets into an altercation with his bodyguard, Big Pat. Now, Big Pat is the same guy that took a bottle to the head when he was in the middle of the Drake fight.
Yeah.
Split his head open
his
and everything.
Head looked like Spider-Man.
Had stitches. Wow. You know, this is Pat, big dude, always watching Chris. This dude gets in an argument with him. So, Chris, you know what? His temper got the best of him again. You know what he did? He left him. He left him stranded in Bermuda. Bermuda.
Wow.
Now, is this how you do someone that protects you on a daily basis? Even if you get into a little quarrel, you leave him in the middle of nowhere?
That sounds like somebody needs some like anger management issues. So,
I thought he was going to anger management.
Rihanna, you better watch out. It's not far, far. She's stepping on my foot right
now. Stop. What?
Do you hear what you just said? And he got a jet and you can't pay that for that $10?
I agree. I agree with you. She needs to watch out.
Yeah.
Because and not only, see, and I only think about it, with it being so deep in Hollywood, Rihanna, you know what? One thing I would say is this. Everybody, some of these famous people, you got Chris Brown, you got Rihanna. Mm-hmm. You got so many little girls and boys at home that notice that he beat her.
Yeah.
And they notice how she went back to him. And I'm not even saying nothing bad about that aspect. But it's a simple fact that when you know you got a guy with a temper and he hit you once and that temper haven't changed, why do I think he would never do this again?
Yeah.
It's the same order if you got a vicious dog that bit you one time and every time he see you every other time, you see him being vicious, but when he see you, every once in a while he drop his head and he wag his tail. Eventually, once you get upset again, he's gonna bite you again.
Look, in the words of Jonathan Banks, if it happened once, it can happen twice.
Right? It can happen again.
Remember, once it can happen twice.
So I hope for Rihanna this never happened. But I'm not even talking to Rihanna, really. I'm talking to all of you, the viewers. This, if you in a relationship like that, I'm not saying get out of there, but understand what happened. He got upset, and he balled his fist up and he chose to put his fist against your face, which is something that's not normal for just two regular, for male and female. So if he did that, his care about you is not on the highest level. Mm-mm. So he must have cared less about you to hit you like this. So I think that's a situation that either you need to try going through some counseling first. Mm-mm. Well, I think you should leave first and let him go through counseling to get himself together, or just don't go back at all.
Yep, that's real talk.
Mr. Banks has spoken.